Welcome to Nalla Narasimharedi Education Society Group of Institutions. This is Kameshwari. My subject Watershed Management, final year first semester, R18 regulation. In that, we are taking principle of soil erosion and its control measures. In that unit, we are already discussed soil erosion, what are the different conservation methods and techniques for control of preventing soil erosion. And now we are going to discuss about bench terracing. That bench terracing, it can be used in downhill side. The purpose of this one is it is an engineering soil conservation practice, and also it is also called as bench terracing. The figure shows the bench terracing. And this can be used previous years, 2500 years ago. And also the objectives of this one is conserve soil moisture and fertility and to facilitate cropping operations. And applications of this one, the slopes up to 30% can be used in that type of ways. So we can go for this test. And the location and conditions where it can be used, mainly the purpose is areas which small holding and a dense population, and also areas where crops required flood irrigation. And the different types of terracing are level at tabletop bench terrace, and also sloping inverse bench terrace, and sloping outward bench terrace, conservation type bench terrace. So we can discuss today topic types of bench terracing. We can see what is meant by level or table top bench terrace. Level or table bench terrace are suitable for areas received medium rainfall, areas having high permeable and deep soils. So it can be called as tabletop terrace or paddy terrace. So built in areas with moderate rainfall and high permeable and deep soils. Such terracing are used for growing paddy, and it is useful as a means uniform impounding of water. So in that areas where rainfall will be medium rainfall and also permeable and deep soil, high permeable soil like sandy soil, like sands, sand construct when compared to clay, highly permeable and deep soils. In that way we can go for this type of soils. So the figure shows the original slope and shoulder burn filling and final shape. This is the bench terracing, cutting and filling. So this is cutting and filling, like this way bench terracing. So in that area, so low area, low rainfall, medium rainfall areas and high permeable areas, we can go for table or level bench terrace. And this is the original pic shows the bench terrace. So like step by step, cutting and filling. And the sloping inverse bench terrace, sloping inward terrace. So this sloping, it is useful areas receiving high rainfall and is useful for crops suitable for water logging areas. So where it can be used in before case, we can use it for medium rainfall, but here receiving areas heavy rainfall and crops suitable to water loading runoff towards hillside. So original slope, cutting, shoulder burn and filling, final shape. So here filling, so this is filling. Here plants and cut, excavate the soil and place the crop and then soil filling. So original land profile and cutting land. So like this way, cutting and fill shoulder and fill shape. Run off towards hillside, inverse the, so inverse slope where the excess rainfall is drained off at earliest into the inverse slope. So inward, so opposite curves, the figure, this one is upward, this one is inward slope. And sloping outwards bench terrace, the cutting shoulder filling, slope outwards, the figure is like this way. The difference between two, inward slope and outward, the curves is opposite direction. So the outward bench terrace areas low rainfall and permeable soil of medium depth at lower ends, graded channel are provided for safe disposal of runoff. So water will be disposed in a safe velocity and discharge to the water in a disposal way. And areas of this one is used for low rainfall and permeability of soil, low rainfall and permeable soil of medium depth. And conservation type bench terracing. So what is conservation terracing? So conservation means conserve the soil moisture. So root zone conserve the holds the soil to reduce the soil erosion. So uniform moisture for uncropped areas. Barrier is established across the land at suitable interval, and the terrace is developed by pushing soil downhill and subsequent natural leveling. So modified form of level terrace. So use moisture of uncropped areas. Barrier is established across the land at a suitable interval. This is the another one, conserve type of bench terrace figure shows. And what is the advantages of bench terrace? The advantages of bench terrace is reduce the soil erosion, aesthetic value, intensive land use, economically beneficial, availability of food for local areas. So this main is used for where food will be need in that availability of food for local area. And also flood chances can be reduced by using this terracing. Flood chances can be reduced, minimized, improve the condition of the slope for plant establishing, and also reduce runoff velocities and increase infiltration. So reduce the soil erosion, reduce the runoff velocities, and also increase the infiltration, and also reduce the flood chances. And the disadvantages of this one is can be complicated to design and install, and may fail if not properly designed and installed. So during design, in that way, proper design, if not properly designed and installed, so that can be problem. So highly labor demand and time consuming. So for designing of this terracing, time consuming and require more labors, and also increase cost relative to alternative slope stabilization techniques. And some of the examples over the world by using terracing in the northern and 2000 BC, and also Sauternes in France, Lebanon hillside, and also level bench terracing in Japan. And this is the bench terrace, Bhutan. These are the in different ways using terracing, Bali, Pakistan, Gracie terraces, and these are the different ways. So these are the bench terracing used for this. So reduce the soil erosion, reduces the erosion losses, increase infiltration, and also required more peoples for implementing this one. So thank you.